Lembre-se, seu divertimento também depende de você. Open up your hands, lift your feet off the ground, take the weight off your shoulders. Remember, your enjoyment also depends on you.
The closing ceremony of the 2016 Rio Olympic Games, and the scene is certainly set, and once again we return to the Maracanã Stadium, which incredibly less than 24 hours ago was the site of arguably one of Brazil's greatest Olympic victories in the men's football. Over 11,000 athletes who will now forever be known as Olympians, well, their work has been done. And the scene is now set to celebrate the Olympic Games, the first Games in South America. The sport has been tremendous and Rio's backdrop has been glorious. The party is set to begin, but before it does, let's take a look back at the Games of the 31st Olympiad, Rio 2016.
Boys and girls that transformed the world into the planet of dialogue, the universe of the digital magic. Always believe in your dreams.
Boa noite, cariocas. Boa noite, Brasil! These first ever Olympic Games in South America will go from Brazil to the entire world. And now let us celebrate all together. Olympic Games a la Brasil!
Thank you. Thank you.
And we finished the look back of the 16 days of glory here at the Olympic Games in Rio, celebrating the last of Brazil's gold medals in the volleyball today. It was an emotional victory, and just 24 hours after the football victory to Brazil as well, bringing their total gold medals to 7. The scene is set. The crowd is filling in. There has been some rain about, but I think, Graham and Duane, that it might hold off for the closing ceremony. Well, weather experts?
Yeah, well, how kind that would be. Certainly, the weather does seem to have cleared ever so slightly. It was coming down a little earlier, but there is the Olympic flame. It's in this very venue some 17-odd days ago now, and 16 days of competition later, and it will be only burning for another couple of hours. The Rio de Janeiro Olympic Games finally concluding here tonight, but what a sensational games it's been overall. A record number of 87 national Olympic committees claiming a medal at these games, more than any previous Olympic Games. And it just tells you about the growth and how much variation there is and how much growth there is in the Olympic sporting codes around the world. And I think that is sensational and really is testament to how sport in general and the pool of talent around the world is growing.
Well, Graham, over 11,000 athletes at these Olympic Games in 2016, and it has been a great sporting Olympic Games, so many moments.
Yes, I mean, Rio de Janeiro has put on a great Olympic Games, and there were questions asked going in, but they have done the business, and they have really proved that that Brazil, South America can produce and host such a wonderful sporting event, and the stories that we've had come out of these games, and the medals and all the drama is there to be seen. But it's also the people. The people have made these games as well. The people of Rio de Janeiro have been incredibly inviting and friendly. And we've seen this every single venue that we've gone to, that the people have just been so, so friendly.
Well, it was spread right around Rio de Janeiro, these Olympic Games. Of course, the majority of the sports were based at the Baja Olympic Park. Duane, you spent a little bit of time here at this venue, the Maracanã, and the transformation is quite incredible. 24 hours ago, this was a football field, and now we see it in all its glory, waiting for the closing ceremony of these Olympic Games.
Well, indeed, the hallowed turf of the Maracanã has been covered over with various synthetic layers that will prove to be the floorbed of this closing ceremony. But indeed, the transformation is spectacular, completely different from a venue that was brought so dramatically to life last night and the penultimate day of competition, as Neymar, the golden boy of Brazilian football, scored the goal that brought... or scored the penalty, the winning penalty strike in the shootout against Germany that brought Brazil their only Olympic gold medal. And it just, for Brazil, it was so important because it was the only medal that they had never won, the only title they'd never won in world football. And to win this Olympic gold medal, so significant for the 18 squad members involved to be Olympic champions as well. But for the Brazilian psyche to win the footballing gold, this is a football-frenzied nation. I think so dramatic, so important, so significant to so many.
I think Brazilians were walking with a spring in their step today after that. I think it stopped the nation. And I think that anybody that was in even close proximity to Brazil or Rio would have heard the screaming going on as that penalty shootout took place. But again, the nation has been glued to television screens in watching the volleyball result today, where Brazil beat Italy. It was also a close game. So again, they've finished in the last 24 hours with so much pride. And they will certainly be filled with pride for this closing ceremony. 16 days of official competition, of course. The opening ceremony took place here on day zero. And we had a couple of days of early football matches prior to the opening ceremony. So 16 days is kind of moving into 18 days in the modern Olympic Games. A lot of the theme of these Olympic Games has been about the environment, about being responsible. And I think this cauldron has been a bit of a hit.
I definitely think so. I mean, the opening ceremony had a message, and Brazil really, has it is the garden of the world, really. And that was very much the message of the opening ceremony, and the fact that the cauldron is a lot smaller, and using these the lights and the spinning mirrors to to give off the glow of the Olympic flames, and yet being and basically being an environmentally friendly Olympic flame.
Well, we look forward to seeing in years to come how the 11,000 seedlings that will be planted on behalf of the 11,000 athletes will grow, and they'll eventually be out there. I think, Dwayne, it's going to be called an Olympic forest. Is that what they ended up with?
Yeah, well, what I love is just the concept, though. I mean, they haven't done what previous Olympic Games have done. They've come up with something new. They've come up with something different. And this the search for peace with the planet is innovative, and it is something that we're gaining more and more awareness as the days tick on by. And I think the fact that they made it one of the central themes was also particularly extraordinary when you get that this is a sporting event that so often focuses rather on the athletes than on peripheral issues. But the opening ceremony proposing this new attitude towards preserving the planet and reinforcing the message of being ecologically conscious and responsible throughout these games, I think was a huge step.
And it also went on to the victory ceremonies as well. Everyone will remember the little logo being yes. given to the athletes. So the athletes were like, where's my flowers? What's this? When they first got it. But the whole idea was like, you give them flowers, they just get thrown away. And this is something that the athletes can keep. And it's a 3D image of the Rio 2016 logo that they got to keep. Though some of them were trying to use it as a medal holder.
I liked that.
Yeah, it didn't quite work. And they were like, no. We're going with this instead of flowers, because you just throw the flowers away, and this you can keep, and it's like keeping your memories.
One thing the Olympic Committee do, and it's normally after the Olympic Games, is they present every participant of the Olympic Games with an Olympian's pin. This time round, they're not waiting for the athletes to go home a few months later and presenting those pins. They are giving them here at the Rio Olympic Games, and the medalists also get a second set of pins that they can wear in their lapel forever. Gold, silver and bronze, so they have been presented here as well. We're looking forward to this closing ceremony. We don't want to do the 16 days again. This closing ceremony, you knew I was going to do it. The music of Brazil has certainly played a fundamental part of these Olympic Games and the landscape of Rio. It certainly translates people's soul and the multiple cultural identities of Brazil and Rio.
Well, the crowd are coming into the stadium now, and they're getting ready with the announcements, and we're going to get this opening closing ceremony. I don't know, you've got me doing it now.
Welcome to the closing ceremony.
Well, I think you touched on a key point, Nicole. The diversity of the people is something that has been celebrated. Brazil is a genuine melting pot of cultures, and despite disagreements, generally Brazilians celebrate those differences, and it's been witnessed by the world.
As the countdown to the Olympic Games ceremony, the closing ceremony, it begins, and we begin by honouring the great Santos Dumont. Rio extends an invitation to celebrate the beauty and diversity of its fauna as we take a trip from the perspective of birds. flying around the city's landmarks. And of course, it wouldn't be a ceremony without dance and singing and music.
Choreography just forming iconic Rio landmarks such as Sugarloaf Mountain, Corcovado, and indeed the Arches of Lapa. Corcovado Mountain, of course, which proudly perched the top of it is Christ the Redeemer statue, which is so integrated as part of Rio de Janeiro symbolism and culture.
Sugarloaf Mountain, considered to be one of the world's greatest natural beauties. Sugarloaf stands in thousands of people's photos. Crowds and tourists come in to ride the cable car. Built in 1912.
This percussion and choral singing group are the Barbatuques. Very famous inside and outside of Brazil. So you start to get a sense of what this closing ceremony is going to be about. Color movement, music, a celebration of Brazil.
Campeão olímpico em esgrima em 1976 e presidente do Comitê Olímpico Internacional, Thomas Bach.
Thomas Bach, president of the International Olympic Committee, Olympic gold medalist himself. Seeing proceedings, closing of Rio 2016.
Meu coração. coração. Não sei porquê, bate feliz quando te vê. E os meus olhos ficam sorrindo e pelas ruas vão te seguindo, mas mesmo assim foges. Ah, se tu soubesses como eu sou tão carinho, muito mundo que te quero. E como é sincero, meu amor, eu sei que tu não fugiste, mas me vem.
This part of the ceremony celebrates and pays tribute to the great maestros of Brazilian music, particularly from the neighborhood of Vila Isabel. This is Martinho da Vila, and he's on stage accompanied by his three daughters and his granddaughter.
Very much a theme of culture in Rio de Janeiro, and if music be the food of love, play on.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez vous lever pour l'hymne national du Brésil.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem.
So now
of
it's time
Brazil.
For the national anthem and the flag of Brazil to enter the arena.
Para o hino nacional do Brasil.
The anthem will be sung by 27 children representing the 26 states plus the federal district.
Thank you.
Brazilian national flag raised as the anthem is sung. And carrying the Brazilian flag was Maria Bueno, one of the greatest sporting icons ever to come out of Brazil. The Brazilian tennis legend decorated 11-year career, and in 1960, the first woman to win all four Grand Slam doubles titles in a year.
As Duane and Graham, we now get into a celebration of the hero of the games, Carmen Miranda style. The flair and the style she projected Brazil's name internationally in the mid-1930s, the golden age of radio. She conquered the world stage and cinemas.
Mesdames et messieurs, les drapeaux des délégations des Jeux Olympiques
Rio 205 nations, 207 delegations in total, for the first time a delegation representing the refugees of the world, and also athletes competing under the IOC flag. The athletes will enter the arena together, but first of all, we recognize the flags of our nations and the flag bearers of our nations. Some of the great stories of the games and some of the best performing athletes for their nations have been given the honor of carrying their flags in the closing ceremony.
I think one of those that stands out is Simone Biles of the United States of America. Of course, the way she performed her floor routine was utterly exceptional, and her gymnastics throughout this Rio 2016 Olympic Games was exceptional and peerless.
Well, it was an Olympic Games for the teenagers as well, with Penny Oleksiak from Canada, who won the 100 metres freestyle in a dead heat to Simone Manuel from the USA. Penny Oleksiak is carrying the Canadian flag. She's just 16 years of age.
And carrying the flag for Ethiopia is Almaz Ayana, who got the athletics underway with an incredible win in the women's 10,000 metres.
Well, carrying the South African flag right near the front, silver in London 2012, gold in the women's 400 metre here. Caster Semenya becoming only the second South African woman to win an athletics gold for South Africa. Wade van Niekerk, of course, claiming South Africa's other athletics gold medal, breaking the legendary Michael Johnson's 400 metre world record. And that's certainly been seen as one of the more significant athletics achievements in the modern era.
What an Olympic Games team Great Britain has had. Their best Olympic Games, best performed Olympic Games ever, and carrying their flag is Kate Richardson-Walsh. She's a four-time hockey Olympian. They had an unbeaten campaign here in Rio, and they have won Great Britain's first ever hockey gold medal.
Yes, Team GB, the first nation to win more medals after hosting a Games than when they actually host it. So New Zealand, their flag being carried by Lisa Carrington, the canoe sprint gold medalist.
Les athlètes!
And now, here they are, the heroes of the Rio 2016 Olympic Games.
So as all of the flags do enter the arena, the athletes will start coming into the arena as well.
Jogos Olímpicos Rio 2016.
11,544 athletes took part in these games here in Rio.
Well, that's celebrating the diversity of Brazil as well, and the culture that exists here in South America, and this enormous country, fifth largest by area, Brazil.
Well, this marching together of athletes in a closing ceremony actually commenced in 1956 when a Melbourne schoolboy wrote a letter to the Olympic Committee suggesting, as a sign of unity for the world, why shouldn't the athletes march together in a closing ceremony? And it's taken place since that time. Carrying the flag for India as we see more of the athletes coming in. Sakshi Malik was the first Indian female to win a wrestling medal. She won a bronze here, given the honor of carrying the Indian flag into the arena.
I think one of the amazing things, though, is just how many athletes are carrying their mobile phones in this modern era of social networks and social media. Of course, this is so important, trying to capture moments for posterity. Just about every athlete that enters has got the camera up, or indeed a cell phone, a mobile phone up, trying to catch a shot of something that they won't certainly forget.
And one of the great messages from this Games is that the Olympic ideals are spreading across the world now, because there are a record 10 nations that have won their first ever gold medals at these Games. The Ivory Coast, Fiji with the men's rugby sevens, Puerto Rico, Tajikistan, Singapore, Vietnam, Kosovo, Bahrain, Jordan, and of course the independent, the IOC independent flag.
Well, the Singaporean gold medal went to Joseph Schooling, 21 years of age. He won the 100 metres butterfly, beating Michael Phelps. So a moment that he will remember forever, and Michael Phelps was then part of a triple dead heat for a silver medal in that 100 metres butterfly. And Fiji, they had a national holiday.
Oh, for Sir Kulunitau's side, captaining Fiji to their first ever Olympic Games medal, and it happened to be gold in the men's rugby sevens. Not to mention, though, I think Kut Ewa's first ever Olympic gold medal is another special one indeed. Cheikh Salah Cisse in the men's 80-kilogram taekwondo, inside the final second of his bout, he needed 4 points for a kick to the head. And within a couple of milliseconds, it seemed like, he had snatched gold away from Great Britain and claimed his country's historic first ever gold medal. It was one of the most enthralling finishes and truly, genuinely emotional for both athletes in the final. That was special for Cote d'Ivoire, not to mention Melinda Kilmendi of Kosovo. Kosovo, one of two delegations competing at the Olympic Games as an independent nation for the first time, along with South Sudan. Melinda Kilmendi, she's ranked number one in the world in her weight class coming into these Olympic Games, expected to win gold, and she didn't disappoint, the judoka winning the women's 52 kilogram.
And what incredible Games it was for the American teenagers. Three 19-year-olds all winning gold medals. Ginny Thrasher claimed her first gold in the Rio Olympics in the women's 10-meter air rifle. Katie Ledecky won 4 gold medals in the pool and set 2 world records. And of course, Simone Biles, who's carrying the flag and is the flag bearer here at this closing ceremony, won 4 stunning gold medals in the gymnastics hall on her Olympic debut.
I hope you're enjoying the music. It's the sounds of one of Brazil's leading voices of a new generation of Brazilian popular music. It's Roberta Sá, and assisted on stage by DJ Dolores and orchestra Santa Massa, along with DJ Mika Muti. Sounds fantastic, and I'm sure the athletes are just waiting to get into the arena to start dancing and celebrating.
The various athletes representing a host of nations, 207 delegations in total that are being represented as they march into the Maracanã, spiritual home of Brazilian football, world football indeed. But to see so many of the athletes who claimed medals, and indeed for many first-time Olympic experience, they are Olympians. It's a title that nobody could ever take away from them now. They've represented their countries on the greatest sporting stage of them all. Athletes like Kaori Icho of Japan, the 32-year-old wrestler who secured her place in the pantheon of Olympic greats after becoming the first woman to win 4 individual gold medals at 4 consecutive Olympic Games. That was outstanding. And again, another captivating display from Usain Bolt of Jamaica. It's his 30th birthday today. How auspicious. He says this is his last Olympic Games. Usain Bolt, 3rd consecutive Games that he won the 100 meter, 200 meter, and 4x100 meter. The triple treble, as he refers to it, and he equals some of the greatest athletes ever, like Paavo Nurmi, like Carl Lewis, like Larissa Latinina, who achieved 9 gold medals. Only Michael Phelps, with his record 23, has more.
And we put a birthday celebration on for Usain Bolt, this little shindy. 11,500 of his world teammates and another 60,000 in the stadium.
Well, I mentioned the American teenagers, the three 19-year-olds. The old men were represented well at these Olympics. Nick Skelton, and he won't mind me saying this, at 58 years old, won the individual show jumping title for Great Britain. And a great story as well on the water. Santiago Lang won a sailing gold medal at the age of 54. But not only that, he was coming back from recovering from losing half a lung to cancer. He was sailing in the new NACRA category, the mixed class, and his sons, both sons, were sailing in the 49ers. And as he came across the line and he won the gold, his sons were just coming back from one of the round robin seeding events, and came back and they jumped out of their boat and they jumped into his boat. And yeah, it was very, very emotional scenes out on the water.
Well, I'm not sure what Nick Skelton, the 58-year-old gold medalist, was doing when he was 15, but Ren Qian was winning gold here in the women's 10-metre platform diving at 15 years and 180 days old, born in 2001. She is the youngest gold medalist from Rio 2016.
Well, speaking of superb Chinese performances, of course, we shouldn't go further than the diving. The first ever athlete in Olympic history to win five gold medals in diving, Gu Mingxia of China. Another thoroughly impressive display. Another gold medal to add to her impressive tally of five now. I think we've got to look as well at the sports that were returning to the Olympic Games. Rugby in the form of sevens and golf in the form of individual stroke play. And you can't say they're disappointed. I think certainly we've spoken about Fiji winning Fiji's first ever medal, happened to be gold in the rugby sevens. But the final between the Australian women's rugby team and the New Zealand team for the gold medal, a trans-Tasman rivalry, proved to be incredible. Australia crowned the first ever rugby sevens champions after they beat New Zealand in the final. And the golf, two major champions going down the 72nd, Justin Rose, Henrik Stenson. Justin Rose hitting a hole-in-one though on his way to becoming golf's first Olympic champion in 112 years.
Just as we see the French come in there, a little quirky fact for you, the boxer Estelle Mosley of France became the first French woman to claim an Olympic gold medal on her birthday.
You mentioned rugby sevens and also golf there. They have both previously been in the Olympic Games. Rugby sevens for the men were in the Olympic Games 92 years ago and golf 112 years ago. When we think about the Olympic Games, and we will start to celebrate the handover to Tokyo 2020, there are some new sports coming to the Olympic Games. We'll talk a little more about those shortly, but it certainly gives a lot of athletes that have never been Olympians, never had the opportunity to be Olympians, the chance to start also dreaming about going to the Olympic Games.
We're trying to get a new angle.
Good perspective.
So now that will be posted on some social media networks.
Some of the other flag bearers that you can see are standing now, making a walkway for the athletes to come around. For Chile, Barbara Riveros, who was in the triathlon, had a top 10 finish, carrying their flag. And for Denmark, Pernille Bloom, who won the 50 metres freestyle in the swimming competition, is carrying their flag.
And we just see the GB women's hockey team coming in now as well. And their flag is actually being carried by Kate Richardson-Walsh. And first time that the British women have qualified to the final and went to win a gold, surprisingly, against a very strong Dutch team.
And that's what it's supposed to be like. Tunisia dancing with France surrounding them. The Russian flag bearers, in fact, there's two of them out there, and the reason there are two is they were successfully defending their gold medal from London in the synchronized swimming duet of Svetlana Romashina and Natalia Ishchenko. Both of them have now won 5 Olympic Games gold medals each.
I just noticed that the Team GB have shoes that, that light up when they dance.
Carrying the flag of Cambodia is Chiroka Son Sivmi. She won Cambodia's first ever Asian Games gold medal. She follows in the footsteps of her sister Davin, who carried the flag in the opening ceremony in London. She carried the flag in the opening ceremony here. She's carrying the flag in the closing ceremony as well. Finished in 11th rank in the women's 67 kilogram. China, more and more very impressive performances for the People's Republic of China. Their diving gold medals, but most notably, their table tennis collection continues to grow. They've won 23 now of the last 24 available gold medals in table tennis at the Olympic Games. Good medal performances though from Team Great Britain. You might talk about Adam Peaty in the pool. Oh, another world record display from Adam Peaty.
And the first British man to win a gold medal since 1988, Adrian Morehouse. In fact, the 100 breaststroke has been a successful event for Great Britain, but he was so far in front. And when you think about dominant performances in the swimming pool, Katinka Hosszú, who is carrying the flag for Hungary, her performances were outstanding. She won 3 Olympic Games gold medals.
Carrying the Puerto Rican flag is Jaime Espinal, the men's freestyle wrestler in the 86 kilogram. He finished with an 11th rank as well, but I think the story for Puerto Rico was undoubtedly Monica Puig's tennis gold medal in the women's singles, the first ever gold medal for Puerto Rico. That was celebrated for some time. It was an intriguing tennis tournament throughout Rio 2016. And Puig claiming Puerto Rico's first ever gold medal. Another enormous achievement.
Remember, this is a celebration of the Olympic spirit. It's not just about the winners. This is about recognizing all those who took part, all those who maybe did not perform at their best. They've still committed 4 years of their life to get to these Olympic Games. And all those who had to withdraw through injury, all those who didn't go so well. You know, as Baron de Coubertin said, the important thing in life is not the triumph, but the struggle. The essential thing is not to have conquered, but to have fought well.
Australia, alongside that of the International Olympic Committee flag that was raised for athletes who marched under the banner, the refugee team, which was an historic first. And indeed, the Kuwait National Olympic Committee has suspended the 9 Kuwaiti athletes who qualified as independent athletes, competed under the IOC flag, and one of them winning a first gold medal, Fahad Aldehani, men's double trap shooting. with the cauldron in the background. The athletes make their way into this venue from the only entrance available to be used by the organizers. The Maracanã, a football venue, doesn't have the number of entrances to the stadium as an athletics track does. So it limited the options for the organizers for both the opening and closing ceremonies. But this venue, just such a part of the Brazilian psyche and so entrenched in the culture of Brazil that there was virtually no other option.
Germans come in. Christopher Hartung of Germany won the men's discus, following the footsteps of his brother Robert, who was the 2012 Olympic champion. It's the first time two brothers have won a gold in the same event. Talking of brothers, though, Alistair and Johnny Brownlee got very close to doing the same, but it was Alistair who defended his title, and Johnny moved up from a bronze in London to a silver here in Rio. The two brothers placing in gold and silver could not be any better for the boys from Yorkshire.
Not to mention the Bender brothers from Germany, Lars and Sven, who finished silver medalists to the host nation Brazil in the football final. As twin brothers, they were looking to become gold medalists together. Claimed Germany's first ever men's Olympic football tournament gold.
A little bit of rain now starting to fall, but not going to spoil the party or the parade for the athletes. Some of them with their medals around their neck. They are quite heavy medals in 2016.
Well, here is Colombia, Team Colombia, blessed by the talent that is Catherine Ibargen, who after winning silver in London 2012, came into Rio 2016 in the women's triple jump, having gone 34 major international competitions undefeated, and she did not disappoint. And she ended up with a gold medal in the women's triple jump. And carrying the flag is the bronze medalist in the boxing, Ingrid Lorena Valencia Victoria.
As the pace starts to heat up a little bit on this giant dance floor at the closing ceremony, this is Frivo. It's an artistic tradition synonymous with hot, lively parties marked by intense pace of steps, twirls and juggles. It's now very much embedded as part of carnivals in the northeast of Brazil. And it's been declared as an item, an intangible cultural heritage by UNESCO.
Thank you. athletes in the audience giving a roar of approval to the dancers on stage. Athletes from a very successful Team USA who became the first nation to win at least 1,000 gold medals at the Olympic Games. At these very Olympic Games, they topped the medal standings yet again. The United States ahead of Great Britain and People's Republic of China with the Russian Federation in fourth, Germany rounding out the top five. Swedish athletes now, and a couple of milestone gold medals for Sweden. One in the pool.
In the pool was from Sarah Sjöström, who won Sweden's first ever gold medal by a woman in the 100 metres butterfly. She's been the consistent performer for a couple of years, winning, in fact, her first world championship as a 15-year-old in 2009.
Well,
excuse me just for a second.
Well, for just a moment, somebody from Team Australia with a Belarus cap on.
Wasn't Australia's best Olympic Games from a medal tally point of view. Mention the rugby sevens. There's a couple of gold medals in the swimming pool, one in shooting. Modern pentathlon as well, with Chloe Esposito winning Australia's first medal in modern pentathlon in over 100 years. Her brother was also competing in the male modern pentathlon. And also their flag bearer, Kim Crow, now married, known as Kim Brennan. She is carrying the flag. She won the women's single sculls in the rowing. And I mentioned Katinka Hosszú a little while ago from Hungary, who won three gold medals and a silver in the swimming pool, but also winning three gold medals and dominating in the kayak events from Hungary was Danuta Kozak.
The last gold medals to be issued, though, at the 2016 Rio Olympic Games was that of the men's cross-country mountain bike. And indeed, carrying the flag for Switzerland was the victor, Nino Schurter. Showered the mud off. And now the Dutch contingent, Team Netherlands, making their way to the Maracanã. Well, the Netherlands winning both the women's and men's marathon swimming events. The first time that a nation has done this at an Olympic Games. Sharon van Groenewaard, Roovendaal, winning the women's event, and Ferry Veertman winning the men's marathon swimming.
And the Netherlands also great in the road race as well. Anna van der Breggen won gold in the women's road race. In the women's individual time trial, she won bronze.
And Sonne Wevers did something special for the Netherlands as well.
We talked about Simone Biles and how successful she was at the gymnastics with four gold and a bronze. Winning the event that she won the bronze in was Sonne Wevers from the Netherlands, and she's actually carrying the flag as well.
And the Netherlands was strong on the water as well. Dorian van Rysselberghe defended his windsurfing gold medal that he won in London 2012. He was dominant over Nick Dempsey from GBR in the water at Marina Gloria. And Marit Bomeester won the women's laser radial.
Well, Well, the rain has started to come down once again and descend upon the closing ceremony of Rio 2016. And there are decidedly no dampened spirits.
Now, my experience of closing ceremonies as an athlete, I can tell you that this party will go on for quite some time.
Did you ever have shoes like that in your closing ceremonies? You're looking envious of those shoes.
Certainly make the Team GB athletes easy to spot in the audience.
Canada.
I was just going to say, Dwayne, it is winter in Brazil, and it seems as though Team Canada are dressed for the occasion. They look almost like they've got the Winter Olympic uniform on.
One of their star swimmers carrying the flag, Penny Oleksiak, gold medalist in the women's 100 meter freestyle, silver in the women's 100 meter butterfly as well, not to mention a few bronze medals, a couple of bronze medals that she took in the
4x1 and 4x2.
Relays, 4x1 and 4x2 indeed. Oh, these little plastic rain ponchos, just protecting the athletes from some of the...
Well, you may also notice that there is seating area around the arena, so the athletes, after coming in together, will then be part of the ceremony sitting down on the arena.
They are still exposed to the elements down where their seating area is, though. That's still part of the outside of the football pitch that is underneath this stage, this fantastic setting that we have here for this closing ceremony.
Well, a couple of the Greek contingents getting into the spirit of the party atmosphere, the Carnivale in Rio de Janeiro.
Just caught a glimpse of the Argentinian sailor, Santiago Lang, with his family, with his sons, 54-year-old gold medalist. I think it's his seventh Olympic Games.
Well, that story, just a return from something is potentially debilitating and indeed life-threatening, never mind career-threatening, as he did lung cancer. To be competing after part of his lung was removed, and then to win the gold medal. That's virtually unprecedented. Albania. Stadium. Luisa Gega is carrying the Albanian flag, just tucked in behind the Canadians. Luisa Gega, the 3,000 meter steeplechaser.
Well, those Canadian mitts that they were wearing, they were the big hit of Vancouver 2010. You could not get a pair of mitts for love nor money after they wore them in the opening ceremony of those Vancouver Games.
Sounds like a good idea for a fundraiser for the Canadian team. And they continue to enter the arena. Over 11,000 athletes. Some of them wearing a little bit of bling.
Let's not forget that the very first Olympic Games, the very first medal of these Olympic Games was actually claimed by Team USA as well, as we saw a shot of a few of the US athletes. Ginny Thrasher, who won the women's 10-meter air rifle.
Talking of bling, the Swarovski crystals that were sewn into the gymnastics leotards of the American team. I think that the actual cost price of a leotard was something like, is into the region of thousands of dollars.
Some of those sports, including rhythmic gymnastics, synchronized swimming, the costumes, from an equipment point of view, it is very expensive, but very much a part of their performance as well.
Flag of Bosnia and Herzegovina. Amel Tuka carrying the Bosnian flag. He carried it at the opening ceremony. Just marching into the Maracanã once again. Unable to quite achieve what he was hoping to in the 800 meter.
Now they're getting into it. Team Ukraine, they've entered into the seating area and enjoying the music. Team USA, it was, in terms of their numbers, in 2012 they were at parity for men and women. This time round, the women just slightly more than the men in terms of the numbers.
Bosnia-Herzegovina, both in the Balkan region of Europe. I saw the flag of Argentina a moment ago, and some of the Argentine athletes. Paula Pareto having brought the Argentine flag into the Maracanã after her victory in the women's 48 kilogram judo.
I saw the Italians enter the arena, 349 athletes as part of their delegation in 295 events and 30 sports in total. In terms of their medal tally, they won 8 gold medals. Judo, fencing, shooting was successful for them, cycling, and also Gregorio Paltineri won the 1500 freestyle in the swimming pool.
Well, there's an intriguing delegation of their own. They will host the next Olympic Games, the Japanese delegation. And
a nice touch.
Very nice touch, as they did at the opening ceremony. Japan, Japanese flag one side, Brazilian flag on the other. And it just illustrates the symmetry between the two and a symbolic of the handing over as well from Brazil to Japan.
556 athletes in the Japanese team competing in 314 events. They had a pretty successful Olympic Games. They won 12 gold medals in total. And those gold medals, well, they had the swimming pool, athletics, badminton. They also did well in artistic gymnastics.
Judo and wrestling, certainly the two sports that Japan dominated. But judo are expected to claim a few gold medals. The likes of Matsubaka and Haruka Tachimoto.
And of course, in 4 years' time in Tokyo, karate will make its Olympic debut.
Yes.
Along with skateboarding.
And surfing.
Surfing, of course.
Rock climbing.
Excited about surfing, sorry. Rock climbing.
Sport climbing, yes. Indoor sport climbing.
And it will be quite spectacular as athletes climb against each other.
And the return of baseball, softball for the Tokyo Olympic Games of 2020 is one that'll be very welcome in Japan.
16 competition for baseball and softball.
Well, the Tokyo Dome, one of the great venues to watch baseball. Tokyo hosting the Games in 4 years' time.
Ukraine won two gold medals at these Olympic Games in terms of their delegation. As we see, the Japanese team still entering. 218 athletes. Five silvers and four bronze for a total of 11 medals. Doing a wonderful performance on stage.
And no doubt welcome to the athletes, the fact that the rain is, it hasn't stopped, but it's certainly not quite as heavy as it was a short while ago. It's perhaps just a shade heavier than a drizzle currently.
Well, that's all of the athletes in now. They've just got to work their way down the line of flags. And then around either side, they're going to come down and then spill out on either side.
Flags of so many nations. Ireland, Egypt, Chinese Taipei. What success they had in the weightlifting. Su Shunqing. The women's 53 kilogram gold medal at the Rio Centro venue.
That's Miles Chumley Watson, the fencer. Men's foil team silver medalist. That move is called the dab.
Have you not heard about it?
Yeah, well, my daughter told me that. It's a dance move known as the dab.
Yes,
and it comes from a sporting reference, so you're dabbing the sweat off your brow.
I have three children who are very proficient at the dab.
There is also an orchestra out on stage on the arena. The orchestra's conductor is Spock, and he's a member of the orchestra Santa Massa. Gwen Jorgensen breaking the drought for the USA in triathlon. They had only won a bronze medal on the Olympic appearances from triathlon since 2000. And that was in the women's triathlon in 2004. And Gwen was a convincing winner in the women's triathlon.
Team Great Britain shoes have certainly lit up this parade. It marks the end of what was a fabulous collection of sporting achievements. Some historic highs, many first times, so many personal achievements and milestones that heroes were humbled at these games, and indeed new heroes born. What punctuated Rio 2016 as well was once again, I think, just the unpredictability that sport provides, and constantly we're reminded of just what a great sense of pride that gives us, what a sense of astonishment, what a sense of joy it brings.
And heartbreak.
It's the overwhelming emotion from every angle. More memories to be captured.
Forevermore, they will be known as Olympians. You're never a past Olympian or a former Olympian. You are an Olympian.
Belgian contingent, saw the Danish contingent a moment ago.
They won their second gold medal,
but
the last day of competition.
Yeah, right.
Handball.
One of the more impressive performances, I thought, was Nafisatu Tiam's win in the heptathlon. Over seven events, she managed to beat out the likes of Jessica Ennis-Hill, Brienne Teeson-Eaton of Great Britain, the defending champion, and the wife of Ashton Eaton, the men's decathlon champion of Canada, Brienne Teeson-Eaton. What a performance by Tiam to win the heptathlon.
A great reveal. You need to keep it dry, though.
you won three, Nicole. It's the first time it happens. How long before you actually take it off?
Well, the first night you sleep with it, that's for sure, under the pillow to make sure when you wake up in the morning it's not a dream. And I think as years go on, you probably live to regret how hard you went with your medal in things like the closing ceremony and when you first get home, because they do sometimes get banged up a little. But they stay there forever. People talk about world records. World records do get broken, but medals and performances, oh, they last forever.
Looks like all the athletes are now in position.
Among those athletes, Dilshod Nazarov, the man that brought Tajikistan his first ever Olympic gold medal.
Music changes, the flag bearers make way.
Seating still watched over by that Olympic cauldron, looking stunning in the darkness of this Olympic stadium.
Mesdames et messieurs, les athlètes de la 31e Olympiade.
Ladies and gentlemen, the athletes of the 31st Olympiade.
So the heroes of the games are now
os atletas da 31ª Olimpíada.
7,544 athletes of the games of Rio 2016. We know you've enjoyed watching the Olympic Games 2016 and the Olympic Games over the years, and now you have the opportunity to enjoy the Olympic Games 365 days a year as we celebrate the launch of the Olympic Channel, which is a free digital platform showcasing the amazing athletes of the Olympic Games.
Yeah, this is DJ Kigo from Bergen in Norway spinning the decks, and Julia Michaels singing the song Carry Me.
Athletes showing that they've got a little more rhythm than others. The Olympic Channel just highlighting a few Olympic athletes dancing in their time at the Athletes Village throughout these Olympic Games.
Original programming, live sporting events, news and highlights bring you closer to these Olympic athletes who sometimes do their sports a little bit better than they dance. No, most of the time.
So the Olympic Channel offers to be a great behind-the-scenes look at the Olympic Games and the dedication and hard work that goes in to all of these athletes and all of these wide range of Olympic sports.
Channel where the games never end, inspired by sport.
Back to the celebration of Brazil, and it's time for the art of the people. This is the archaeologist Nij Gideon
He's responsible for discovering and preserving cave paintings in the Serra de Capivara. It's in a national park in Brazil.
Dancers performing choreographed moves representing various entwined shapes, freely inspired by the indigenous repertoire.
Transforming the different geometric patterns in reference to the shapes used in braided fabrics and straw. Reflective moment now, the remember moment during the 2016 Olympic Games here in Rio. For the first time in modern Olympic history, there was a place of private mourning provided for the athletes in the Olympic Village.
Because everything is here embodied.
And the Olympic family here in 2016 lost one of their own, with Stefan Hens from Germany, an Olympic silver medalist from the canoe slalom in 2004, here as a 2016 canoe coach, unfortunately, tragically passed away in an accident. So we take a moment to reflect and remember lost ones.
The poem being read out, Saudade, which means nostalgia or missing. I don't miss what I experienced, because everything is here, embodied inside me. I miss what was experienced by those I lived with. Not what I saw, but what they saw. Not what I heard, but what they heard. And what was dreamed and felt by people I lost.
Not what I saw, but they saw. Not what I heard, but they heard. What they dreamt, what they felt. The people I lost.
Now to the Mulla Rendira, the lace-making women, as we pay tribute to black culture's contribution to the formation of Brazil.
Protagonists singing the lines, Mulla Rendira, lace-making woman. Giant piece of lace that's growing out from the central characters, connecting all the characters in the scene. We're representing the power of the collective work and the special art of these women. Little pieces of wood are used to make lace, and needles that hold the threads together made from cactus spines. So delicate, so complex, but it's tradition. The tradition has passed from generation to generation.
Tribute now, celebrating the greatest exponents of the art world, clay, the figurines and the dancers come to life to the music of one of Brazil's greatest geniuses, the king of Baum. Thank you.
is Grupo Corpo, created in 1975. And this particular dance is Parabello, one of the company's memorable shows.
Now we turn our attention to the performance on the main arena from the stage. This is a celebration of clay. Clay is formed from the decomposition of rocks, and rain causes it to settle on riverbanks. But more importantly than that, it is what Brazilians have used to model the Vitalino, the cast of clay figurines that come to life. And one of Brazil's greatest geniuses, the king of bailao, Luis Gonzaga. At this moment of the show, we want to make the audience dance to this as the clay figures come to life.
And the dance they're doing is the foro. It's derived from English for all. And it's a good old-fashioned shindy.
They do say that this dance might originate from the American bases, the American military bases in the northeast of Brazil during the Second World War. Dances were held for all to come through and dance, and
it's working.
The athletes are joining in. Coming to life to dance to the
Casabranca. And it's a good job the rain has stopped because the clay would melt.
From clay to reliving and reflecting on some of the magical moments of the sport here at the 31st Olympiad of Rio 2016. They were a tremendous games, and in tradition of the Olympic Games, it's time now for the victory ceremony for
Mesdames
the men's marathon.
La cérémonie des vainqueurs du marathon homme.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the men's marathon.
Senhoras e senhores,
during the first edition of the Olympic Games in 1896, all of the medals
masculina.
Were handed out on the last day. And in the modern games tradition, the last medal of the ceremony is the men's marathon. We'll meet the medalists in just a moment.
Please welcome the medalists.
Por favor, deem as boas-vindas aos medalhistas.
Les médailles seront remises par Thomas Bach, président du Comité international olympique.
Representing the International Olympic Committee presenting the medals, Thomas Bach.
Accompagné de Lord Sebastian Coe, Grande-Bretagne, président de l'Association internationale des fédérations d'athlétisme.
The medals will be presented by Thomas Bach.
With Lord Coe in presence as well.
Representing the IAAF, the National International Federation.
Accompanied by Lord Sebastian Coe, Great Britain, President of the International Association of Athletics Federations.
As medalhas serão entregues por Thomas Bach, presidente do Comitê Olímpico Internacional, campeão olímpico esgrima 1976, acompanhado por Lord Sebastian Coe, Grã-Bretanha, presidente da Associação Internacional de Federações de Atletismo.
The victory ceremony.
Médaille de bronze.
The men's marathon will start with Galen Ruffy called up to receive his bronze medal. Well, he must be a delighted man. He's been on an Olympic podium before. The USA cross-country star who took silver in the 10,000 meter at the London Games earned marathon bronze in only his second time ever running that distance. 2 hours, 10 minutes and 5 seconds, and he's congratulated by the president of the International Olympic Committee, former Olympic gold medalist himself, Thomas Bach. Lord Sebastian Coe, another former Olympic gold medalist, an IOC member from Great Britain, the president of the International Association of Athletics Federations.
Médaille d'argent, representant l'Ethiopie. Silver medalist, representing Ethiopia. Medalha de prata, representando a Etiópia,
Faiza Lilesa. It's Faiza Lilesa, a very emotional performance as he crossed the line. Let's just hope his medal can spread the Olympic message of peace to his troubled land. Ran in a time of 2:09.54.
After all that distance, the distance separating silver and gold was 1 minute and 10 seconds.
Médaille d'or. The champion olympique,
and after winning Olympic medals
Kenya,
on the track in the 5000, a bronze in Athens, a silver in Beijing, it was the marathon that finally
Olympique
brings him a gold medal.
Kenya, Eliud Kipchoge
of Kenya, 2 hours, 8 minutes, 0.44. Kenya claiming both the men's and women's marathon, with Jemima Jalagat Sumgong winning the women's. Pause to hear the national anthem of Kenya.
Mesdames et messieurs, l'hymne du Kenya.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Kenya.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino do Kenya. Thank you.
victory.
Mesdames et messieurs, les médaillés olympiques.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic medalists.
In front of 60,000 fans here at the Maracanã.
Os medalhistas olímpicos.
And the athletes of the Olympic Games from all sports watching on this medal presentation ceremony.
Special moment as well for Kenya with the opening ceremony where Kip Keino became the first ever recipient of the Olympic laurel, a distinction that was created by the IOC to honor outstanding individual achievements in education and culture and development of peace through sport. And now Kenya atop the podium at the closing ceremony. Special now for these three marathoners is the fact that they are standing directly in front of their peers, fellow medal winners, and not just the world's press who are taking photos of them with their medals around their necks.
These athletes train exceptionally hard year in, year out, for a very long time looking for their moment at the Olympic Games. It's important that their voice is also heard, and the International Olympic Committee engages with the athletes through the International Olympic Committee's athlete mission.
Of the International
and whilst the Olympic
Committee
Village has been open here in Rio over the last 25 days in the athletes' village, there has been a vote amongst the athletes for some newly elected positions for the Athletes Commission, and they have now settled on four new members. Around 5,500 athletes voted in this process.
Uma de ouro,
and we're about to meet those four new
Alemanha,
athletes who are representing their peers.
And that is Britta Heidemann, the FAist, gold medal in 2008, and didn't qualify for these games, unfortunately, but silver medal in 2012. One of the talking points of the games was her showdown with Shinalan.
Yelena Isinbayeva, Russian Federation's double Olympic champion from Athens and Beijing. In 2004 and 2008, she officially retired on Friday.
Uma de ouro, uma de prata e uma de bronze. República da Coreia, Sun Min Ryu.
Representing
natação,
career in table tennis,
olímpico de ouro, Hungria, Daniel Gyurta.
And finally, Daniel Gyurta from Hungary, from swimming. So these are the four new athletes for the Athletes Commission, and they do have a new chair.
Au nom de tous les athlètes, des fleurs sont présentées à quatre représentants
Angela,
des milliers de bénévoles de Rio 2016
Rougereau,
en reconnaissance pour leur inestimable contribution au jeu.
And now, on behalf of all
and
the
now
athletes,
we pay tribute
flowers
to
are being presented to
the
four
volunteers
representatives of the
that have
of
assisted all of us at these Olympic Games
in recognition of their invaluable contribution to the Games.
E agora, em nome de todos os atletas, flores estão sendo entregues a quatro representantes dos milhares de voluntários dos Jogos Rio 2016 em reconhecimento à sua contribuição sem igual aos Jogos.
What a fantastic job these volunteers have done, and the athletes giving them a rousing round of applause.
Merci à vous, les bénévoles.
Cette chanson est pour vous.
Thank you, volunteers. This song is for you.
Muito obrigado a todos os voluntários. Essa música é para vocês.
And on the main stage, Lenina will be singing.
Well done to the volunteers and well done to Lenine.
Pour l'hymne national de la Grèce.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem of Greece.
The national anthem of Greece.
Senhoras e senhores,
raising of
por favor, levantem-se para o hino nacional da Grécia.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez accueillir le président du Comité international olympique, Thomas Bach, le maire de la ville de Rio de Janeiro, Eduardo Paes,
et madame le gouverneur de Tokyo, Yuriko Koike, pour l'hymne olympique. Who returns
Ladies
the Olympic flag to the president of the IOC.
The president of the International Olympic Committee, Thomas Bach, the mayor of the city of Rio de Janeiro, Eduardo Paes,
the games
and the governor
of Rio de Janeiro
Tokyo,
start
Koike, for
to
the
close.
Olympic anthem.
We turn our attention to the games of 2020.
Do Comitê Olímpico
and joining
Internacional,
on stage
Thomas
will also
Bach,
be the governor of Tokyo,
da cidade do Rio de Janeiro, Eduardo Paes, e a governadora de Tóquio, Yuriko Koike, para o hino olímpico.
national anthem sung there by children from the Moor Project, which looks to look after homeless children in Rio. Discovered on YouTube and used for the opening ceremony as well.
Now the official handing over of the Olympic flag.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic flag handover ceremony.
Eduardo Amea.
A cerimônia de entrega da bandeira olímpica.
Waves it for one final time as it's handed over to the International Olympic Committee and Thomas Bach.
Le maire de Rio de Janeiro remet le drapeau olympique au président du Comité international olympique, que, à son tour, le confie au gouverneur de Tokyo,
and it's passed along to our next Summer Olympic Games host city. And the mayor, the governor of Tokyo,
of the International Olympic Committee,
Yuriko,
who then entrusts it to the governor of Tokyo, host city of the next Olympic Games.
O prefeito do Rio de Janeiro entrega a bandeira olímpica ao presidente do Comitê Olímpico Internacional, que, por sua vez, a confia à governadora de Tóquio, cidade-sede dos próximos Jogos Olímpicos.
As our attention now turns to Tokyo 2020.
Veuillez vous lever pour l'hymne national du Japon.
Ladies and gentlemen, national anthem of Japan.
What will Tokyo have in store?
Senhoras e senhores, por favor, levantem-se para o hino nacional do Japão.
Of Tokyo 2020 as our performers enter the arena on personal mobility devices wearing costumes inspired by the art of origami. And the headdress and corsets are actually made of paper that have been hand-folded by volunteers and students.
Well, from Japan, the message of arigato, thank you.
And that is the Prime Minister of Japan turning into Super Mario. He's got no time to get to Brazil. And Brazil is the furthest away from
Japan than you can possibly get, and he's Super Mario is going to be tunneling his way into this Olympic stadium.
Oh, fantastic.
Well, in London 2012, we had the Queen of England. Now we have the Prime Minister of Japan, Shinzo Abe.
As we now look at the new sports, the additional sports that will be there in 2020, there will be 33 sports altogether. And of those 33 sports, the IOC recently added baseball, softball, karate, skateboarding, sport climbing, and surfing.
Acrobatic movements being performed by gymnasts from Aomori University.
The night view from Tokyo Bay, the waterfront cityscape of Tokyo.
We'll be right back.
three different types of darts being combined, the Umutinashi Nomai, the Undan Nomai, and the Aragoto Nomai. The hospitality darts, the cheering squad darts, and the thank you darts.
As well, but what has happened to that red ball? Kosuke Katajima, one of the most decorated Japanese athletes, takes hold. Well, if that's an indication, I'm excited about it already. A fantastic showcase of what Tokyo 2020 will be like.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez accueillir Carlos Arthur Nussmann, président du comité d'organisation des Jeux Olympiques et Paralympiques de Rio 2016, président du comité olympique du Brésil et olympien en volleyball, et le président du comité international olympique Thomas Bach, champion olympique d'escrime en 1976.
President of the Rio 2016 Organizing Committee for the Rio 2016 Olympic and Paralympic Games. President of the Brazil Olympic Committee and Volleyball Olympic Athlete. And the President of the International Olympic Committee, Thomas Bach, Olympic Champion Fencing 1976.
Senhoras e senhores, por favor, recebam Carlos Arthur Nussmann, presidente do Comitê Organizador dos Jogos Olímpicos e Paralímpicos Rio 2016, presidente do Comitê Olímpico do Brasil e atleta olímpico de voleibol, e o presidente do Comitê Olímpico Internacional, Thomas Bach, campeão olímpico esgrima 1976.
Boa noite, Rio! Boa noite, Brasil! Good evening, bonsoir! A chuva vem festejar os Jogos Olímpicos Rio 2016. The rain comes to celebrate the Games of the 31st Olympiad. Dear friend, President of International Olympic Committee, the Olympic champion Thomas Bach. Brazilian authorities, autoridades brasileiras, autoridades internacionais, international authorities. I'm the happiest man alive. Eu sou o homem mais feliz do mundo. O melhor lugar do mundo é aqui, no Rio! Just a moment, um momento. É agora. Convido a todos para celebrarmos juntos essa grande vitória. Este triunfo que é do esporte. Let's celebrate together this victory of the sport. The Games of Rio. They will stay forever. Os Jogos do Rio ficarão para sempre na memória e no coração dos homens, mulheres e jovens que foram tocados pela chama olímpica. we celebrate the Olympic flame together with all of you. O Rio fez história, mostrou sua beleza e também sua capacidade de sediar o maior evento do mundo. Rio did the history, show his beautiful but all his competence to organize the most important event of the world. O Rio se modernizou, se transformou. A cidade do Rio, ela é outra. This, it's a better city and still a magic place. Foram 7 anos de muita luta e de muito trabalho, mas valeu a pena cada segundo, cada minuto, cada dia, cada ano. Graças a vocês. Fazer os Jogos no Rio foi um grande desafio, um desafio realizado com sucesso. Did the games in Rio, it was a great challenge, but a challenge with success. É por isso que eu tenho orgulho do meu país, orgulho da minha cidade, orgulho do meu povo. I am proud of my country, my city and my people. We are vibrant people. Somos vibrantes and lovers. Sim, somos diferentes de norte a sul, de leste a oeste. E essa diversidade nos faz tão únicos. From north to south, east to west, these are the diversity of our people. We are unique. Todos os brasileiros são heróis olímpicos. Vibramos juntos, comemoramos juntos e vencemos juntos. All Brazilians are Olympic heroes. We vibrate together and celebrate together. Essas Olimpíadas provaram que um filho do Brasil não foge à luta. Este é o nosso símbolo. Vocês coloriram o Brasil de verde e amarelo. Eu paint the country Brazil in yellow and red. E renovar em nossos corações o orgulho e a autoestima de ser brasileiro. O esporte brindou o Rio com momentos inesquecíveis. E a torcida do Brasil, vocês, têm a medalha de ouro. You are the gold medal of the people who come to see the games in all the planet. Quero agradecer o apoio de todos que contribuíram para o sucesso dos Jogos Olímpicos Rio 2016, a nossa Olimpíada. E o meu carinho agora, de coração, para os voluntários. Voluntários olímpicos, incansáveis. And my heart to the volunteers, the Olympic volunteers of our country and all of the world. We are proud of our volunteers. With a smile in their face, they have put these games together. Com um sorriso no rosto, e eles colocaram os jogos juntos. Sem eles não seria possível. Os atletas Os heróis olímpicos merecem nossa homenagem. Vocês são as estrelas desse grande evento. You Olympic athletes receive our special award. You are the stars, the great heroes. Vocês são a razão de ser dos Jogos. Inspiram jovens. Vocês escreveram uma nova página na história do esporte. You wrote a new page in our Olympic history. You are the heroes. Muitas emoções. 27 recordes mundiais. 91 recordes olímpicos. 27 world records. And 91 Olympic records. Os Jogos Rio 2016, eles ficarão para sempre em nossa memória. A nossa paixão e o que fizemos pelo esporte. The Olympic world belongs to all of us. No frontiers and are open to new horizons, new regions of the planet. When we won the games in Copenhagen, I said, Rio are ready to make history. Quando ganhamos os Jogos, eu disse que o Rio ia fazer história. Agora, eu repito, dizendo, 7 anos depois, o Rio fez história para sempre. We did the Rio has delivered history. From my heart, do meu coração, muito obrigado a todos. And good luck for Tokyo 2020. Thank you.
A very passionate speech from the president of the organizing committee, Carlos Nuzman, who said it was a challenge, but a successful challenge, and all Brazilians are Olympic heroes.
Sorry, with the emotion, wanted to invite the international Olympic president, the Olympic champion, Thomas Bach.
And that Rio
My
has
great
delivered...
friend, and friend of Brazil, friend of Rio.
And that Rio has delivered history, a successful challenge.
Muito obrigado, Cariocas. Parabéns, Brazil! Dear fellow Olympians, Monsieur le Président du Comité d'organisation des Jeux Olympiques Rio 2016, mon cher collègue et ami Carlos Nuzman, distingués représentants des autorités brésiliennes, chers amis olympiques du monde entier, nos te amamos, brasileiros! Merci de votre chaleureuse hospitalité. Au cours des 16 derniers jours, un Brésil uni a animé le monde en ces temps difficiles pour nous tous, par son irrésistible choix de vivre. Vous avez tant de raisons d'être fiers. Ces Jeux olympiques ont démontré que la diversité est un enrichissement pour tout le monde. Jeux olympiques ont été une célébration de la diversité. Nos valeurs olympiques ont créé l'unité dans cette diversité. Un grand merci au comité d'organisation et à son président, mon ami Carlos Nuzman. Notre gratitude va en particulier aux fédérations internationales, aux 206 comités nationaux olympiques et aux sponsors pour leur estimable contribution à la réussite de ces Jeux. Thank you. Thank you to all the volunteers. Your smiles have warmed our hearts. Valeu, voluntarios. Thank you to you, the Olympic athletes. You have amazed the world with your incredible performances. You have shown us all the power of sport to unite the world. By competing in friendship and respect, by living in harmony under one roof in one Olympic village, you are sending a powerful message of peace to the whole world. Together, we can go even further. Together, we can even aim higher. United in our diversity, we are even stronger. Thank you, dear refugee athletes. You have inspired us with your talent and human spirit. You are a symbol of hope for millions of refugees in the world. We will continue to be at your side after these Olympic Games. We arrived in Brazil as guests. Today, we depart as your friends. You will have a place in our hearts forever. Estes foram Jogos Olímpicos maravillosos na cidade maravillosa. These were marvelous Olympic Games in the marvelous city. These Olympic Games are leaving a unique legacy for generations to come. History will talk about the Rio de Janeiro before and a much better Rio de Janeiro after the Olympic Games. The International Olympic Committee would like to honor the people who made this miracle happen. 110 years ago, the founder of the modern Olympic Games, Pierre de Coubertin, created a unique award, the Olympic Cup. Tonight, this Olympic Cup goes to Osh Kariokas. The IOC has invited six of you to accept this cup here tonight.
So the IOC award the Olympic Cup to the people of Rio.
Representando a população do Rio de Janeiro.
Six representatives
por favor,
come
as boas-vindas aos representantes dos programas educacionais e sociais que o Comitê Olímpico Internacional apoia.
Is a record of do merit and integrity
paz,
in developing
Paulo
the Olympic
Ricardo,
movement.
Do Programa das Nações Unidas, uma vitória leva a outra, Marcele. Do projeto Transforma, que auxilia crianças por meio do esporte, Natália. Representando os voluntários do Rio 2016, Michele. Da equipe de construção que ajudou a transformar a cidade, Francisco e Renato Sorriso.
So the six people invited onto the stage represent social projects within Brazil.
So Thomas Bach
talked of the power of the world to unite, and we've shown that here in Rio, that by living in friendship and harmony under one roof in the Olympic Village, we can send a powerful message of peace. Thank you to the people of Rio for hosting us for the 31st Olympiad.
After 16 glorious Olympic days, I now have to perform my last official duty here in Rio de Janeiro. I declare the Games of the 31st Olympiad closed. In accordance with tradition, I call upon the youth of the world to assemble 4 years from now in Tokyo, Japan, to celebrate with us the Games of the 32nd Olympiad. Bye-bye, Rio.
So he makes the call out to the youth of the world to assemble in 4 years' time in Tokyo, Japan, for the Games of the 32nd Olympiad in 2020.
Well, the party's not over. Chance for the Brazilians to put one more colourful display on. This segment plays tribute to the great Brazilian artist and landscape designer, Roberto Burle Marx.
Dressed in costumes inspired by Brazilian species of flora, just performing a series of choreographed formations, but integrated with the projection contest, transforming the stadium into a vast Burle Marx garden.
Like a swirling human lava lamp.
These costumes were produced by the Association of Women Entrepreneurs of Brazil, which was founded 18 years ago to train workers through community workshops and to help strengthen the carnival-related creative industry.
Representing other creative areas of this multifaceted artist, the shapes and colors of watercolor drawings to Copacabana's promenade.
as our attention turns to the cauldron. Goes out on these Olympic Games 2016 of Rio de Janeiro. Marianne de Castro is the singer.
So the water that has put out the Olympic flames, also responsible for the renewal of life, fire and water.
Now the epicenter of the scene, the large tree that's there, symbolizing the rebirth. And now the party begins. The carnival march that becomes an anthem. It's a city with enormous musical talent.
Well, the music, Cidade Maravilhosa. In the 1960s, this became the official anthem of the city of Rio de Janeiro. And it's the official anthem of the carnival, and it's got them dancing in the stands.
Well, the locals affectionately refer to their city as Cidade Maravilhosa, the marvelous city. And it is conceivably the carnival capital of the world. As this carnival march plays, the stands are full of the Maracanã of dancing cariocas.
By five sets of traditionally dressed summer dancers, the dance masters and flag bearers. We'll be right back. Isabel Goulart, one of Brazil's acclaimed models, and Renato Sorriso, who is a waste collector and a staple of the Rio Carnival, dance across the stage together.
A famed dancer, certainly, at the Sambodromo. He was one of the torchbearers for Rio 2016. He participated in the London 2012 closing ceremony 4 years ago in anticipation of this carnival that would be the Games of the 31st Olympiad. And one of the most valuable models in the world alongside him.
Have been filled with human endeavour, spirit and unity from the athletes around the world. And as the Games of the 31st Olympiad have come to a close, we hope that the Games have filled you with inspiration. And we certainly look forward to your company on the Olympic Channel. the Rio 2016 Olympic Games come to a close with a burst to the sky of the fireworks over the Maracanã. We've enjoyed each and every moment over the 16 days and we look forward to Tokyo 2020. But for now, we will enjoy the final stages of this celebration, the Carnival of Rio 2016.